Oh, there
Hello,
she is.
beautiful.
Hello. You look so gorgeous. You look so stunning.
So are you, darling?
So,
What's happening? हम लोग
are you
सब
wearing a traditional saree?
हाँ
So, lots of people are right now asking about KGF 2, and sure, you're shooting for it, and it's a
yeah.
pan India release. Tell me something about it. How excited are you? And is this your first South Indian movie?
No.
Okay.
This is my ninth or tenth South Indian movie. I've done Kannada movies before. Very big hit that was Upendra. It's known to be one of the classics there. Then this is my second Kannada movie, but like I said, it is like a pan India kind of a movie because it's mostly
Yeah.
all languages, and it was very very exciting. As you know, you know that I take up very less work, and until and unless it doesn't excite me, I don't take up work. Been there, done that kind of scenario. But this was something that really excited me because I'd not played a character like what I've played here because she is positively gray. Now, I don't know how you can describe that. It's a very difficult thing. So it's that kind of a character that was difficult to play because neither couldn't you be the complete villain of the story, but you are also a positive character because I'm playing the Prime Minister in the movie, and everyone says it's a takeoff on Indira Gandhi, but no, it's not. Yeah, but it is just it talks about the 70s and 80s, so I think everyone assumes a PM, Lady PM in. You know, I could be Sheikh Hasina for you know for all you know. So it's not necessary to you know be just categorized or that you're playing somebody's role. But it was a tough role. It was very difficult. It was a pleasure shooting with Prashant and Yash. They're such wonderful guys. Such a wonderful unit. I love shooting in the South. I love the people of the South. I love shooting down South. It's always such a pleasure, you know. So yeah, I enjoyed that, and I'm looking forward to KGF as much as all of you are.
All the Sanjay that is a part of this movie, he would be seen in a negative shade, is what I've heard. Will we get to see you guys like on screen? Because that is going to be very exciting. You guys might come after a very long time if that happens.
No, actually, we are not together in this movie as such. We are together, but not together, so to speak. But it like I said, it is very exciting, and I don't think I can reveal that much about the movie, but wait and watch. It'll be fun.
One question to you, like, you know, Kanika Kapoor has been detected with coronavirus. You are very vocal on social media, and even Sonam Kapoor, you know, tweeted recently about her. So what do you have to say? Like, you know, do you
See,
think
you know,
she's actually not
yesterday, I
feeling
mean,
it?
honestly, I was on a news channel, and what they actually told me was that they want to know my opinion about the PM's, request to for this lockdown, and that is what I was prepared for. So I did not actually, know much about what Kanika had done, or I had not read up on her, honestly. So I was not aware, and then suddenly they threw that question to me, and later on, when I watched the news, they'd only kept that question on Kanika. So I was like, where did the rest of the interview go? You know, I was like, वही पूछना था, तो you should have just told me if you want to ask you about the Kanika Kapoor controversy. So at least I would have read a little or known what had happened. I didn't know what had happened, honestly. Then last night I caught up on the news and I came to know about the entire controversy as to what had happened. I mean, the very contrary reports that are coming. Someone says that she tweeted something, and is it true that she tweeted something this afternoon that I don't know now what all is happening. So there's so
She
much.
tweeted something for sure, but there is no clarity whether, like, you know, it's from her
Yeah,
end
so
or is it?
exactly. So one can't
Yeah.
really say, at this point that what her situation was, whether did people check her, did she really lie about her not getting fever? What I feel is in those days during the holy time, everyone was partying. Me and the kids definitely did not go out. Me, Anil, and the kids, we stayed at home. In fact, every holy we go to meet my parents. This time I told my parents especially that, please, y'all don't also venture out, and even we will not come because this is affecting the senior citizens the most. And we
Yeah.
stayed at home, and amongst ourselves only, we, played with little color, organic color and stuff. You must have seen the video on my Insta. It was
Yes.
just me, Anil, and the kids, and my mom-in-law, and my entire staff,
Yeah.
which is my resident staff. They all,
Yeah.
Like I told you that the outside staff, we've given them advances and, you know, leave and said, please don't come till this tide's over. So the thing is that, you know, we really haven't stepped out of the house. We really haven't been doing anything. So people need to be aware. So was she aware? Was she not aware? There are all these questions that only she can answer. But yes, in these times, one has to be really, really responsible. You have to know that even if you're young and your immunity is strong, but you could be passing it on to someone who's senior, whose immunity is probably not as strong as you, because even if you don't get the virus, you can just be someone who transmits it, someone who's just a carrier. So one has to be very responsible. And like I told you earlier also, we are citizens. Hamari bhi zimmedari banti hai equally. Abhi government ke sab blame karte, government aise nahi kiya, government. Arey government har ek gali mein ek chaukidar thodi rakhegi aapko dekhne ke liye aap ghar ke andar kya kar rahe ho. So aapki civic sense honi chahiye. Everyone has to have civic sense. You know, and the people need to have civic sense. People need to be responsible. So coming back to Kanika, this was about people and about citizens. But coming back to Kanika, all these questions that only she can answer. We don't know what the situation was.
So what are you doing tomorrow since it's a lockdown completely and it's a janta
country? Movies, books, my children are doing online studying. We are playing Monopoly Deal, we are playing Scrabble, and we are having a great time. It's family bonding time.
Have you watched Tanhaji, which was a period drama? Would you ever do a period drama?
Tanhaji?
Would you be a part of history, or, you know, a movie based on history, or like, you know...
I love Tanhaji.
Yeah.
I saw the movie and I loved it, and that's on one of my to-do lists with the kids now to make them watch it. I just completely loved it. I love historicals. And I would love to be a part of a historical, honestly.
So we might be seeing remake of Andaz Apna Apna taking place soon. And we have heard strong reports that, you know, Rajkumar Santoshi is planning to cast Ranbir Kapoor and Ranveer Singh in this movie. Who, according to you, should be playing the lead actresses? And what are your, you know, how excited are you to see the sequel of this one? Because this one was very close to you guys, for sure.
I think there should be Tara and Alia in this. I think that would be great.
When it comes to digital world, like when it comes to digital movies and all, like, you know, Karishma Kapoor was a part of a digital movie recently. Would you prefer doing a digital movie? Would you prefer, like, you
well, she did Mental Hood, which was that was also one of the series that was offered to me long ago, but I was still not ready to do that many web series at that time. That was from All Balaji. It was a lovely script, but unfortunately, I was busy with, you know, the same dates doing KGF and stuff. So I would have loved to do Mental Hood as well. But unfortunately, that didn't work out. But I'm looking forward to doing one. I have given the go-ahead to one web series now, which we were supposed to be shooting in April. But now I'm sure everything will be postponed. So that's the one that, yes, I am doing now.
If you had to reunite with any of your co-stars, you know, who would that be on big screen?
You know, I think it would have to be Shah Rukh. Because Shah Rukh and me actually have a very, very strange history. Because I actually had signed 4 movies with Shah Rukh. One of them, of course, was Zamana Diwana. But unfortunately, what happened with the other movies that I signed, there was a movie called Jadu. Okay. And it had the most amazing, amazing music. And unfortunately, the director passed away, and then something happened with the producer. And Shah Rukh and me were so looking forward to that movie. The songs became such a big hit because they released the album afterwards. But, you know, that was what happened with that. Then there was another movie that we signed, which I kind of opted off. And then I didn't even do Dar. So there were 2 movies that I didn't do. Then Chaiya Chaiya was offered to me. And I didn't even end up doing Chaiya Chaiya because I was making a kind of a comeback at that time. And I didn't want to be stereotyped into, oh my God, she doesn't share ki ladki, it just come out. And then it was suddenly that whole thing of, oh, you know, item songs kind of thing. And I was trying to reestablish myself. And that was the reason I said no to Chaiya Chaiya. And so it's the, you know, there were so many opportunities, and whenever we meet, there's so much affection between us, and I really respect him and I really love him. And So it's always that thing that, oh gosh, man, we, you know, could have done so many more movies together and we didn't end up doing.
But since he's not done movies since a long time and he might, you know, bounce back with a lot of projects in his hand, maybe we might see you within a Bollywood, you know.
I hope so, yeah. Yeah, that would be great. That would be great.
Do you think that the lockdown, what, you know, PM has announced for a day, should be extended maybe, you know, because maybe one day would not make that much of a difference?
And I think what they are trying to work is what of some healthcare, you know, friends of mine were discussing. And they were saying, Karan ye hai ke, like I said, the disease mostly stays 12 to 14 hours alive on surfaces. So there is a possibility that they're trying to make it safer and a little more healthier. Ke agar, you know, ye lockdown ho aur koi itna transmit na ho, toh shayad thoda control mein aaye. But mere hisab se ye thoda aur lamba chalna chahiye, kyunki kahin na kahin log samajh nahi rahe, sun nahi rahe. Ab aap Shaheen Bagh ki dekh lijiye. I mean, ye khatam ho jane do aur aap apna protest phir jari rakho. Please protest by all means. We are a free country. Lekin think about your own health. Bahut pehle wo bhi suna tha ki ek baby mar gaya tha thand ki wajah se. To ye kyun apni jaane jokhim mein dal rahe hain? Kyunki that baby had no choice, right? He was too young to say, okay, aap mujhe le jao ki nahi le jao. So I feel there are things which I mean, if this was America, that lady jiska baby mar gaya would have been arrested for child abuse. You know, unka baby, unke baaki bache le liye gaye hote the by child care officials, and she would have been arrested and in prison for literally harming. It would have been homicide. But over here, if agar hamare Indian officials would try karte. So I think they'll again be, you know, abused. So please, Adesh ko suniye, listen to people. It's for your own health and your own safety. Don't try to challenge right now at this important juncture.
We saw you traveling by train yesterday. Where were you up to? And you were cleaning the train like very well, covered also, and, you know, being very hygienic. I hope you carry your own bed sheets because the, you know, the IRCTC people said that, you know, they don't clean their bed sheets every day.
So this wasn't yesterday. I posted the video yesterday because, I mean, even this morning, I thought it was necessary to post that video. I traveled about ded hafta pehle, nearly when, it was right after Holi. And it wasn't so alarming. Hamara level 2 pe nahi gaya tha tabhi tak. I felt it was necessary a video post karna. Because main aaj bhi dekh rahi thi, aaj bhi Mumbai Mirror mein aaya ke, इतने वार्निंग्स के बावजूद इतने सब कुछ हमारे पीएम के दरख्वास्त के बावजूद ऑनरेबल पीएम हैज रिक्वेस्टेड ही हिमसेल्फ डिड नॉट प्ले होली ही हिमसेल्फ कैंसल्ड ऑल द प्लान्स उसके बावजूद लोग पीपल वर स्टिल पार्टिंग उसके बावजूद ट्रेन्स इतनी फुल जा रही हैं आपने भी आज देखा होगा इन मुंबई पेपर्स दैट पीपल literally stepping over each other. ऐसे लग रहा था partition का time वापस आ गया. उनके videos हम देख रहे हैं जिस तरीके से लोग ट्रेनों में भर रहे थे. But it's just necessary for me to post that please only travel. जो आज railways का भी same message आया actually. Today the railways also posted the same message कि please तभी ही travel कीजिए अगर बहुत ही जरूरी हो तो. And that's what then I also thought it's necessary ye message post karna logon ko batana ki please travel only if necessary. And phir maine dala ki maine ded hafte pehle travel kiya tha jab itna alarming rate pe nahi aaya tha hamare desh mein. And tabhi bhi I was wearing masks, I was wearing latex gloves. Hum log ne pura compartment ko sanitize kiya, sanitizers leke gaye the hum log. Usko sanitize kiya, pura clean kiya. And फिर हम लोग ने बेडशीट्स डाले और हम बैठे उस पर यू नो सो इट इज सो नेसेसरी एंड इवन टू टच द डोर नॉब्स एंड द हैंडल्स बिकॉज द कोविड 19 दैट्स द कोरोना वायरस इट स्टेज ऑन द सर्फिस फॉर एटलीस्ट 12 टू 14 आवर्स सो इवन इफ समन हैज पास थ्रू और तभी वो अगर वायरस उसके ऊपर है तो अगर आपने वो हैंडल टच किया ट्रेन का हैंडल या ट्रेन का दरवाजे का हैंडल वो आप पे आ सकता है सो दीज आर थिंग्स विच पीपल आर नॉट रियलाइजिंग ये लोग समझ नहीं रहे हैं कि कितना जरूरी है इस समय घर पे रहना इस समय क्वारंटीन करना और मैं आ गई आई केम बैक अबाउट अ वीक एंड अ हाफ अगो आई हैड फ्लोन मैं प्लेन से गई थी और वहाँ शूट खत्म करके आई प्रिफर टू टेक द ट्रेन बैक, क्योंकि प्लेन का इतना सुन रहे थे हम लोग उस समय, क्वारंटीन हो रहे हैं लोग, ये हो रहे हैं. और मैं वापस आई हूँ और उसके बाद मैं खुद घर से नहीं निकली हूँ बाहर, बिकॉज आई हैव सेल्फ आइसोलेटेड माई सेल्फ. यू नो इट इज वेरी नेसेसरी कि अगर आप ट्रैवल कर रहे हो या कुछ, तो आप आके फिर घर पे रहिए एटलीस्ट 14 दिन, एटलीस्ट 14 डेज.
ऑल्सो लाइक वी हैव सीन यू ट्रैवलिंग बाय ट्रेन, लाइक इन द पास्ट वी हैव सीन योर पिक्चर्स एंड ऑल. सो डू यू प्रिफर ट्रेन ट्रैवलिंग, डू यू एंजॉय ट्रेन ट्रैवलिंग एंड ऑल, व्हाट इज द बेस्ट मेमोरी व्हाइल
यू नो? मेरी बचपन की बहुत ही बढ़िया मेमोरीज हैं ट्रेन ट्रैवल. जब भी हमारी छुट्टियां होती थी तो हम लोग ग्वालियर जाते थे, ग्वालियर जो MP में है, एंड हम लोग यहाँ से पंजाब मेल लेते थे बॉम्बे से, एंड सीधे वहाँ ग्वालियर उतरते थे. तो इट वॉज सच अ ब्यूटिफुल मेमोरी ऑफ ट्रैवलिंग इन दोज हॉलीडेज इन ट्रेन. हम लोग आजकल इतने जो फ्लाइंग इतना अभी लिटरली टैक्सी सर्विस के जैसे हो गया है, तो बच्चे भी दे आर ओनली यूज टू यू नो ट्रैवलिंग बाय प्लेन्स एंड एयरक्राफ्ट एंड दे यूज टू इट. तो आई फील अगर लिटरली ब्यूटी, हिंदुस्तान की ब्यूटी देखनी हो तो ट्रैवलिंग बाई ट्रेन इज अ मस्ट. इट हैज अ डिफरेंट रोमांस अबाउट इट. आई लव ट्रैवलिंग बाई ट्रेन. एंड तो पिछली बार भी हम जब अमृतसर में थे तो हम लोग कॉर्बेट पार्क बच्चों को लेके जा रहे थे, एंड वी ट्रैवल्ड बाई ट्रेन. उस समय कोरोना वायरस का डर नहीं था, तो मास्क पहनने की यू नो वो नहीं थी कंचा, तो मैंने ऐसे ही शॉल से अपना मुंह ढका हुआ था. और किसी और लेट नाइट 3 बजे हमने पकड़ी थी ट्रेन, सो देयर वाज नोबडी रियली हु रियलाइज्ड आल्सो, एंड वी रीच्ड एट अराउंड 12 o'clock इन द मॉर्निंग. वी रीच्ड कॉर्बेट, यू नो, टू ड्राइव अप टू कॉर्बेट. दैट वाज अगेन अ ब्यूटीफुल एक्सपीरियंस, बच्चों को भी याद था. सो मुझे जहां मौका मिलता है ट्रैवल बाय ट्रेन. और इस बार जब मैंने ट्रैवल किया, जब मैं आई वापस शूट से, ट्रेन से जब वापस आई, मैं आपको बता नहीं सकती, आई एम सो सो इम्प्रेस्ड. आई थिंक हम लोग के ट्रेन के स्टेशन इतने साफ हो गए हैं, इट इज द ट्रेन आर सो क्लीन, इतने वेल मेंटेन है, ये नहीं कि आपको गंदगी मिल रही है, धूल मिट्टी मिल रही है. आई वॉज वेरी वेरी इम्प्रेस्ड. आई थिंक पीयूष गोयल जी इज हैंडलिंग our you know railway ministry right now. A big congratulations to him, because and his predecessor who was there before him, kyunki ye this cannot be an overnight change. Definitely it has taken about 5 to 10 years to bring it to this situation, but I'm very impressed. Time pe aayi, time pe nikli, time pe pahunchi. अंदर का सर्विस बहुत बढ़िया था, जितने रेलवे ऑफिशियल्स थे इतने बढ़िया थे, कोई रूड नहीं था. मैं तो मास्क पहनी हुई थी तो आधे लोगों ने पहचाना नहीं, टीसी ने तो पहचाना नहीं हमें, तो पर तभी भी उन्होंने इतने प्यार से, इतनी आदर से बात की. तो आई थिंक आई हैव होप फॉर माई कंट्री, आई हैव होप फॉर ह्यूमैनिटी, एंड आई लव माई कंट्री एंड आई लव इट्स पीपल. मैं इमोशनल हो रही हूँ यार ये कोरोना वायरस के टाइम पे. आई रियली डू, आई मीन आई रियली डू.
आई जस्ट होप योर आईज आर मॉइस्ट ऑलरेडी.
या आई थिंक जितना जितना प्यार, और कभी कभी हम लोग भूल जाते हैं रोजमर्रा जिंदगी में. अगर आप देखें तो हमारे फ्लड्स के टाइम भी, जब मुंबई फ्लड्स हुए थे, सब मुंबई वाले उतर गए थे एक दूसरे को मदद करने. आपने एक रेप का इंसिडेंट नहीं सुना होगा, एक वायलेंस का इंसिडेंट नहीं सुना होगा. जब ऐसे ट्रबल टाइम्स आते हैं तो आई थिंक कहीं ना कहीं इंसानियत जाग उठती है, नहीं तो लोग रोज बिजी होते हैं, अरे ठीक है अपने आप को संभाल लेगा. एंड आई थिंक उसी समय न्यू ऑर्लीन्स में कुछ साल पहले भी फ्लड्स हुए थे, और न्यू ऑर्लीन्स में इतनी वायलेंस थी, इतने रेप केसेस हुए, इतनी लूटिंग हुई, यहाँ पे शॉप्स की भी लूटिंग नहीं हुई. तो आई फील यू नो समवेयर एज इंडियंस आई एम प्राउड व्हेन आई हियर स्टैटिस्टिक्स लाइक दिस. इवन नाउ आप देखिए तो इटली में रायट्स हुए हैं because of coronavirus. There was complete unrest. अभी मुझे WhatsApp videos आए हैं London से that there is unrest in London. I don't know the genuinity of it, क्योंकि WhatsApp में कभी कभी पुराने भी videos नए करके कर देते हैं, so I don't know if it is fake और अभी का है, but there is unrest there. But I'm proud about one thing, that you know so far we haven't heard anything yet about our country, and I hope के लोग rules follow करें. I hope जो हमारे PM ने कल का एक आदेश दिया है कि आप घर पे रहिए, इट इज लॉजिकल, इट इज सेंसिबल, एंड हैट्स ऑफ टू ऑल आर यू नो डॉक्टर्स एंड आर यू नो हेल्थ केयर सर्विस, जितने उस सर्विसेज में है, दे आर डूइंग अ वंडरफुल जॉब, दे आर डूइंग ऑल दैट दे कैन, एंड इट्स ऑल फॉर अस. पर हमारी एज सिटीजन्स रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी समीना यही बनती है कि हम आदेश का पालन करें, हम चैलेंज नहीं करें. अभी भी मैं ट्रेन में देख रही थी बेवकूफ लोग, वन कपल गोइंग टू दिल्ली, क्वारंटीन का स्टैंप लगा हुआ है हाथ में, दूसरों की जिंदगियों को जोखिम में डाल रहे हैं लेकिन ट्रेन में ट्रैवल कर रहे हैं. तो ये सब न करें आप अपनी जिंदगी की. तो यू नो, अगर आप स्ट्रांग हैं, यंग हैं, आप ठीक हो जाएंगे, लेकिन आपके बगल वाला शायद ना स्ट्रांग हो, यू नो. सो यू जस्ट स्प्रेडिंग द डिजीज.
But somewhere, do you feel that this will have a, you know, a very adverse effect on our economy, and like, you know, somewhere there would be a slowdown, and like, you know, there would be, you know, financial crunches and all, and how should we cope with such things if something like this happens?
Samina, there's going to be a huge slowdown. This is going to hit economy not only in India, worldwide. But right now, since we are talking about our country, there is going to be an enormous setback. Already we were going through a slight recession, and then this has hit us, which is going to be, it'll take some time to recover. What I really feel bad about is that maybe a lot of us have already saved, you know, have some savings, unless the bank hasn't looted you, because nowadays you don't know which bank is going to take away your stuff. And so, you know, all of us probably still have our savings, you know, put in somewhere for a rainy day, and we probably bank on that. But what about those daily wage workers or those staffers? I've heard a lot of hotels have actually sacked nearly 50 to 70% of their staff, which I think is really sad to do at this time of the crisis. But maybe they have no choice because they're kind of, you know, edging towards going bankrupt. Airlines are almost on the brink of bankruptcy. So it is a sad, sad situation that we are all going to take time to recover from. But as far as jump के हम लोगों की बात है, चाहे वो हमारे सब्जी वाले हों या चाहे हमारे डेली वेज वर्कर्स हों जो रोज की रोटी घर ले जाते हैं, आई फील जहां तक कि हम उनकी मदद कर सकते हैं, वी शुड डू इट. यू हर्ड अबाउट द फिल्म इंडस्ट्री कमिंग टुगेदर फॉर आवर स्पॉट बॉयज, आवर लाइट मैन. वो तो हमारी फिल्म इंडस्ट्री, आई वाज टेलिंग समवन यस्टरडे आल्सो के आई थिंक वी आर द फर्स्ट टू बाउंस बैक, क्योंकि जहां तक कि अगर एक फिल्म बनेगी हम without spot boys, without lightmen, without our technicians, without even that jo load uthate hain, a film cannot be made. Unke bagair hum picture bana hi nahi sakte. So they are an indispensable part of the film industry. So I know ke jahan filmein shooting hai wapas shuru hongi, they'll all be back to work, lekin jab tak tab tak nahi ho tab tak to hame unki madad karni padegi, aur ek fund to shuru hua hai. Likewise, I request all the industries that don't sack, don't fire your employees. Send, you know, if you can, then let them be at home on a paid leave. A lot of my staff, which was coming, at home from outside working in my house, I have given them advances so that they can tide over the month, and they are on paid leave. They are not on unpaid leave. So I think that is something we should all do on our own. I request the big corporates to not sack their employees, but if you are going bankrupt, then give them unpaid leave. If you can afford it, please give them advances and paid leave, because these guys have families and they have to take back money home every day. And that's where I feel we all can help.
Okay, we saw your photo shoot with Filmfare, and I told you, I complimented you already, like, you look hot.
How so sweet. One tip for, you know, that's because you love me. You know that.
That is true. But like, of course, you're looking very good. You can ask Thank anyone.
You. Thank
what
you.
Tip would you give to all these actors out there who are going for digital covers and like, you know, doing photo shoots and all? How do you carry yourself, that personality, you know, completely comes out?
You know, in the 90s, we had no photoshopping. In the 90s, what you were is what people got. What you saw was what was absolutely real. Nowadays, I think it's a little tough. It's technology helps a lot. But what would my tips be? As in, what would I tell them?
Yeah, like what they should do when they are, you know, featuring on a digital cover or like in a magazine cover.
I don't know. I think it's what this new breed is doing these days is just fantastic anyway, because what I do feel is a lot more of our actresses are doing what models used to do earlier, or being models, or being more fashionistas. So it's a little bit of that, you know, sometimes I feel like doing, you know, stuff which just keeps you a little away from being an actress or a fashionista, you know? So, yeah, I mean, in the sense that I don't know how to say this properly.
Like, more like an influencer. Influencers on social media, like, who do such kind of models and not, like, they do the kind of shoots they do.
Yeah, so it's gone in the very model space, you know. First, we used to have photo shoots like just sitting cross-legged and laughing into the camera and, you know, candid expressions or just expressions. You know, there used to be more close-ups and just expressions and what your face used to be. Now it is, what are you wearing?
Yeah.
You know, now it is more about what are you wearing. It's not about the expression or the mood or, you know, it's... Or just, I mean, even now, if you see the best close-ups or the best photo shoots, whether you see Vahida Rehmanji or you see Asha Parikh ji or you see Madhubala ji, the best close-ups are black and whites and just close-ups. And it's just the expression in the face that is speaking. You know, that kind of photography I miss these days in the new photo shoots.
Being in the entertainment industry must be very, you know, stressing also. It's a stressful thing for sure. So how do you de-stress? How do you take care of yourself and how do you de-stress, you know, when completely unwinded?
You know, when I was not married, I think my de-stress used to be my girls. Or I think it's a selfish need because I used to work for so many NGOs and so many orphanages. I used to come back from a shoot. There were many times that I was misunderstood as well. Like, for example, I remember, I will not take the name of a film, but I remember I was shooting somewhere right in the beginning and we were at, you know, at a shoot where the ice cream people had sponsored us. And there was so much ice cream lying on the set. And I went to the guy and asked him, "Iska kya hoga abhi?" You know, ice cream ka itna sab packed it. They packages. They were like packed in those ice boxes. And he said, "Ma'am, sab phek denge hum log because, I mean, you can't." So I said, "Okay, theek hai, just load up my car, you know, with it." And I took all that ice cream, you know, home. So I told them, "Hey, you know, send it." And I remember the hero at that time was there and something happened. So someone must have told him, "Or Raveena, you know, is taking these ice creams home." Whereas I was not taking them home. I had other plans. And I remember throughout that shoot, that hero was loudly teasing me. "Ah, sara ice cream Tandon ko de do, sab de do." And I just kept quiet because I was not the kind to flaunt these things. But as soon as pack up happened, I took that entire load of ice cream and I went to my orphanage, that Mud Island orphanage where I used to go. And me and the kids opened the wraps and I spent the night with them. I used to actually spend nights at the orphanage. I used to put the gadda down with, you know, on the floor with the girls, spend nights with them and tell them ghost stories and stuff. And we used to have so much fun. And, you know, so these are things which I would not talk about in public. Because I always felt that, you know, oh, people in 2 seconds say, "Arey, dekho, ye PR publicity ke liye kar rahi hai," you know. Even though people used to think, "Arey, ye itna ice cream apne ghar le gai." I mean, what would I have done with 30 boxes of ice cream in my own house alone? You know, how much could I have eaten? So these were things that used to go around and gossip magazines used to write such shit. But I didn't care because I knew what I was doing and I knew that in my heart that I'm a happy person and I know where I'm going. Even now when I meet a lot of those girls who were there in the orphanage at that time they were kids, now they're working. There's so many of them who are working at the airports or here and there, and I meet them and say, "Raveena Didi, how are you? And you remember the time when you used to come and spend with us?" And they're all working somewhere or the other. And I feel blessed at that time. I think there's nothing else and more than getting unconditional love from people whom you deserve to give love, and then you receive love.